Hello everybody, today we are going to see solutions of worksheet number 13. Okay, so from that first problem is O is a point in the interior of square ABCD such that OAB is an equilateral triangle. Show that DOC is an isosceles triangle. Okay, I have drawn here figure according to the given information. See once again what is given. O is a point in the interior of square ABC. Here O point is taken and that is in the interior of square ABC. Okay. Such that OAB is an equilateral triangle. OAB is an equilateral triangle. Okay. All the sides are equal, all the angles are equal. Show that DOC is an isosceles triangle. Here we have to prove DOC is an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle is what? We need to prove sides same, okay, any two sides. So here if we will prove that OD is equal to OC, okay, if OD and OC are equal, then we can say triangle DOC is an isosceles triangle. Okay, so first, as we know that OAB is an equilateral triangle, so all the sides are equal, all the angles are equal. So first we will take whatever given things are there. Given what is quadrilateral ABCD. Quadrilateral ABCD is a square. ABCD is a square. Then what is given? Triangle OAB. Triangle OAB is an equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. Okay, these things are given. Now to prove, what we have to prove? Prove that DOC is an isosceles triangle. So triangle DOC is an isosceles triangle. Okay, this is our proof. Okay, so now we know OAB is an equilateral triangle, that is given. So each angle, this OAB is equal to OBA is equal to BOA will be 60 degree each angle. Okay, because that is equilateral. So now in proof, first we will take OAB is equal to OBA and third one angle AOB. These three angles are same. Each angle will be of 60 degree. Okay, from that two angles we will use. OAB is equal to OBA. Angle OAB is equal to OBA. Angle OBA. Okay, 60 degree. This we will say, this is first. Okay, now this is ABCD is a square. Okay, so all the four angles will be of all the four angles are right angles. So we can see here DAB is equal to CBA, it equals to 90 degrees. Okay, angle DAB is equal to angle CBA equal to 90 degrees, that is second one. Okay, so this whole angle is 90 degrees. This is 60 degree. Okay, here also is all the four angles. We are going to use only these two angles because already we have taken OAB and OBA. So we will think about these two angles. Okay, so now this is first and this is second. Now these two angles, each of them is 90 degree and this each of this is 60 degree. So now first we will subtract from second. Okay, so by subtracting first from second. Okay, so LHS minus LHS we will do here. Angle DAB minus angle OAB is equal to angle CBA minus angle OBA. CBA minus OB. Okay, DAB minus OAB. DAB minus OAB is which angle is going to remain? DAO. Angle DAO is equal to CBA minus OBA. CBA minus OBA means CBO. Angle CBO. Okay. And this is 90 degree. 90 minus 60. 90 minus 60 will be 30 degree. So each of them, this angle DAO, and CPO is equal to 30. So this we will say third one. Okay, so now we got this angle. This angle is equal to this. That is 30 degree. Okay, so now we will think about these two triangles. Triangle. So now in triangle AOD and triangle AOD and triangle BOC. BOC. OA is equal to OB. Okay, because equilateral triangle. Sides are same. OA is equal to OB. Okay, it is given. Equilateral. They have told us this is an equilateral triangle, so sides are equal. Then OAD, angle OAD is equal to OBC, angle OBC. Okay, each 30 degree. Okay, or of all angle, both the angles are same. So this is from third. Okay, so here we can give reason from third. And AD is equal to BC because this is a square. So all the sides are equal. So we can write, we can take here AD is equal to BC. AD and BC are equal. So it is also given. All sides are equal. Quadrilateral ABCD is a square. Quadrilateral ABCD is a square. So we have two sides and one angle, one included angle. So by side, angle side, we can say both the triangles are congruent. So triangle AOD. Congruent triangle BOC by side angle side. By SAS criteria, both the triangles are congruent. Okay. If triangles are congruent, the remaining sides are congruent. Okay. And what is our target? We have to prove triangle DOC is an isosceles triangle. Triangle DOC is an isosceles triangle means we need to prove DO is equal to OC. Okay. And DO and OC are the corresponding sides of both congruent triangles. Okay, so directly we can say DO is equal to OC by CPCT. By CPCT, DO and OC are equal. So we can say triangle DOC is an isosceles triangle. Triangle DOC is an isosceles triangle. Okay. Okay, so second problem from the worksheet number 13 is in figure two sides AB and BC and median AM of one triangle ABC are respectively equal to sides PQ and QR and median PN of triangle PQR. Show that triangle ABC congruent triangle PQR. Okay, so here once again see two figures are given. Figure two sides AB and BC, AB and BC and median AM of one triangle ABC are equal to sides PQ QR and median PM. Okay, and then we have to prove triangle ABC congruent triangle PQR. Okay, ABC and PQR. Here two sides and median of this triangle are equal to the two sides and median of the triangle PQR. Okay, so now first what we will do, we will prove here triangle ABM and triangle PQN are congruent. Okay, so for that we need to do here BC and QR is equal, that we will use first. BC is equal to QR. BC and QR are equal. Why? That is given. BC and QR are equal. And we know that AM and PN are the medians of both the triangles. So median bisects opposite side. Okay, into equal parts. Bisects means equal parts. So here we will take here half of BC is equal to half of QR. Okay, both the sides we have taken half. Then half of BC, we can say half of BC is BM or CM. And half of QR, we can say QN or NR. Okay. So here half of BC, I am taking here BM is equal to QN. BM and so this is, we will say first. Now we will think about triangle ABM and triangle PQN. So in triangle ABM and triangle PQN, ABM and PQN. PQN. What we can write, AB is equal to PQ, that is given. AB is equal to PQ, given. Then AM is equal to PN. AM is equal to PN. Okay, median. AM and PN mediums are equal, that is also given. And third thing, BM is equal to QN. Okay, which we have given here proof. That is, we will say from first. So BM is equal to QN, that is from 1, that is from 1. Okay, so all the three sides are equal. All the three sides of triangle ABM and three sides, corresponding sides of triangle PQN are equal by SSS, side criteria. We can say triangle ABM congruent triangle PQN by SSS, side. Okay, so now here these two triangles are congruent. ABM, this and this triangles are congruent. But our target is different. We have to prove ABC congruent PQR, whole triangle. ABC and PQR are congruent. That is our target. So now, if triangle ABM and congruent triangle PQN, ABM and PQN are congruent, then we can say angle B is equal to angle Q, CPC, corresponding part of congruent triangles. Okay, angle B and angle Q are same. Now we can think about triangle ABC. This I am saying, this is second one. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR, triangle ABC and triangle PQR, AB is equal to PQ. AB is equal to PQ because that is given. Then ABM or ABC, okay, angle B is equal to angle Q. So instead of angle ABM, we can write angle ABC. Angle ABC is equal to PQR. Angle PQR. ABC equals to PQR. Okay. Why? From second. Reason we will give from second. Okay. And third thing, BC is equal to QR, which is given. BC and QR are equal. So that is given. Okay, so side angle side by SAS criteria, side, triangle ABC, congruent triangle PQR by SAS, side angle side. Okay, by SAS criteria, both the triangles are congruent. Got it? Here, everybody, this is very simple, sir. Thank you. Okay, see here, one more problem we are going to see, that is from NCERT exercise 2. From that first question is, in an isosceles triangle ABC with AB is equal to AC, the bisector of angle B and C intersect each other at O, join A to O, show that OB is equal to OC and second AO bisects angle A. AO bisects angle A. Once again see, in an isosceles triangle ABC with AB is equal to AC, AB and AC are equal, the bisectors of angle B and C intersect each other at O. Okay, so that is BO is the bisector of angle B and CO is the bisector of angle C. So definitely these two angles OBA, OBC and OBA are equal. Also here OCB and OCA are equal because OB and OC are the bisectors. Then join A to O, AO, join A to O, so that OB is equal to OC and AO bisects angle A. So first we will think about OB is equal to OC. Okay, so now in triangle solution, in triangle ABC, AB is equal to AC. AB and AC are equal. AB and AC are equal, that is given. Okay, because that is isosceles triangle. Triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. So now here we can see angle ABC is equal to angle ACB, angle ABC and ACB are equal because isosceles triangle, the angles opposite of equal sides. Okay, angles opposite of equal sides. Equal sides are equal. Okay, so angle ABC and ACB are equal. Okay, so now here we can take half of this. Half of angle ABC is equal to half of angle ACB. Okay, so half of angle ABC we can take OBC. Okay, OBC, angle OBC is equal to half of angle ACB, we can take OCB. Okay, angle OCB. Understood? So OBC and OCB are equal. This angle and this angle, base angles are equal. So we can say triangle. So triangle OBC is an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle. So we can say OB is equal to OC. Angles opposite of sides opposite of equal angle. Sides opposite of equal angles. Sides opposite of, if these two angles are equal, the side opposite of equal angles are same. If this BO and OC are equal. So that was our first question. Now we will see second. AO bisects angle A. AO bisects angle A means here we have to know this angle means BAO is equal to CAO. Okay, that we need to show you. So here we will use this two triangle, triangle AOB, triangle AOB and triangle AOC, triangle AOB and AOC. AB is equal to AC, that is given. AB and AC are equal, that is given. Then OB and OC are equal. Okay, and which we can use, AO is equal to AO, that is common side. So by SSS criteria we can show both the triangles are congruent. So here AB is equal to AC, that is given. Then AO is equal to AO, which is common side, and BO is equal to CO. BO is equal to CO, that is BO is equal to CO. If we will say this is first, then here we can say from 1, BO is equal to CO. So by side, triangle AOB congruent, triangle AOC. Now these two triangles are congruent. So we can say BAO is equal to CAO. Angle BAO is equal to angle CAO. Corresponding angle. These two angles are corresponding angles. Okay. So now here we can say by CPC. Okay. So these two angles are equal. Then we can say AO is the bisector of angle A. AO is the bisector of angle A. Okay. So these two questions are there from exercise NCERT exercise 2 from that first question.